President Eden. I'd like to have a chat. Enclave is back, America. And no, not just on your radio. Right now, Enclave troops are patrolling the capital wasteland. These fine men and women, under the command of the stalwart Colonel Augustus Ordem, have one mission: the restoration of American peace and order. But let's hear from the man himself, shall we, America? I give you Colonel Augustus Ordem.
Thank you, Mr. President. People of the Capital Wasteland, I am Colonel Ordem. By now, you have encountered Enclave troops in your towns, in your settlements. You see the Enclave. You see the United States government. We are authorized to restore order and civility by any means necessary. Just stay out of the way and let us do our job. Interfere with the Enclave's mission, and you will be dealt with harshly.
Very good, Colonel. Very good. So, there you have it, my darling America. Enclave troops are now in your neighborhoods, in your lives, in your hearts. Together, we'll restore the glory of this great nation. One problem at a time. So remember, Enclave is working around the clock to return this country to greatness. All you need is a little patience, a little faith. Till next time, this is... inspirational quotes from the mouth of your president, John Henry Eden, straight to your heart. Avoid popularity if you would have peace. This is President Eden, and you're listening to Enclave Radio, the voice of a nation. Stand now and presence. A great nation once more threatens to crumble, to topple into the sea of lawlessness and despair that have ruled us all for over 200 years. In short, my dearest America, we are at war. Even as I John Henry Eden, and you're listening to Enclave Radio, the voice of warmth and reason in this cold, unreasonable world. This is John Henry Eden, your president. Some things we should talk about. That's all right. I've been thinking quite a bit lately about something we can all relate to, something that is unquestionably innocent.
each state had its own professional baseball team. Imagine. Perfect, cloudless day. The sun is warm, welcoming. And on the horizon... country in the world to its former glory, well, that takes time, even for the Enclave. Until we meet again, this is your president, John Henry Eaton. Federal government, Washington, D.C., has been reduced to what is now known as the Capital Wasteland. The Capital Wasteland. How did it come to this, America? How did your leaders allow the most powerful nation on Earth to die? The answer is really quite simple. Incompetence. Incompetence at the highest echelon of power. Our faith in half-wits. Our intrepid leaders had everything they wanted. Power, wealth, prestige. And it made them lazy, America. Oh, yes, and laziness breeds stupidity. Rest assured, I will not make the mistakes of my predecessors. When John Henry Eaton builds a country, he builds it to last.
listening to Enclave Radio, the voice of America. Hello, my beautiful America. This is President Eden, and it's time we had a talk. It's time we discuss something rather important. The issue at hand is, well, my presidency. The question has been raised, I know, as to just how I came to be elected in this most illustrious office, or whether or not I have been elected at all. To that, I must answer, of course. Of course, I was elected, sweet America. Of course. Isn't the right to vote the very foundation of the vote? Fortunately, the interest of national security, I'm not at liberty to discuss the details of the election. You understand. But rest assured, I am your president. Because the appropriate people of this great nation decided that I should be. I am your duly elected representative. Of course.
Come out,
when
fucker.
The time comes, when I turn it up, America will be free to elect a new president. So, wave and confidence and carry our collective values forward into the future. Democracy, dear America. Democracy, now and forever. We've got a part now, you and I. But don't be sad, America. The Enclave is working tirelessly to rebuild this great nation. So you don't have to until we meet again. This is your president, John Locke. One of my inspirational quotes from the mouth of your president.